David, having a performance like that on this stage and a night like this means what to you?
I'm just happy he was able to continue playing a good brand of basketball and get a win against a really good team. I think number one team in the West right now in the world. I was really proud of that, but I don't think anybody feels like we walked away as a winner tonight, you know, with given the circumstances. The memories that were taken away from me was, you know, just sad. It was just tough. It's good that, you know, we had to compete, so being on the winning side is a positive, but I don't think anybody walks away from this moment in this situation.
Through all that beautiful celebration before the game, what's your perspective of that being out in the floor and seeing all that?
I think it's tough, you know, from an emotional standpoint, but he's worth it. More than worth it. You know, that type of love and that type of respect and that type of honor that was given to him, you know, in the first game since it happened, you know, it was only right. And, compared to what his family has to deal with, you know, his closest friends have to deal with, us having to, you know, honor him in that way and then play a game is a small thing. You know, I think for what we do in our careers, this is what we do. And arguably the toughest competitor to ever play the game, I felt like it was only right for us to pay our respect pregame and then go out there and honor him by competing, you know, at a higher level. Both teams did that.
What was it like for you to play in this game?
I tried my hardest to just, calm the emotional part of the body down and just go out there and play. And I think for both teams, it was a rough start to the game because it's hard to go from being in that type of mental state and watching and listening and, you know, jump into a game and, you know, really care. So for me, I just, you know, I tried to keep my emotions in check and just play the game, you know, have fun and go out there and compete. And that was that.
What stood out to you about the pregame stuff, that, you know, being out there and witnessing all that firsthand?
Just how many people he touched. You know, I think the first thing we think about is the legend that he was as a basketball player. But I think the impact is just so strong that you just see the emotion out of so many different people for so many different reasons. And that just stood out. The amount of respect that he had and what he left behind. Unbelievable.
You said you tried to push those emotions down a little and just play. After it was over, did you have a moment or anything? Was there a reflective moment, an emotional moment?
No. I don't know what else to say about this. It's just a tough situation. And I think everybody just feels it on the inside. Just like, you know, it's such an unbelievable thing. It's such a sad thing that you just can't wrap your head around it, you know. But I'm not trying to make a situation about me and how I feel and all that stuff. You know, it's just a sad feeling on the inside. You know, you just feel really bad. And, you know, that was that. When the game was over, like I said, it was a great game, but I walked off the court. You know, it was nothing to be super hyped up or proud about because, you know, you're walking out and it's on your mind. So, that was it.
How would you describe your mindset in that third quarter where you quite literally put your team on your back and took over the game?
I know at the half, I thought we played a pretty solid first half. And I knew it was going to be tough to come in here and pull a win out. So I just wanted to come out and be aggressive and assertive in the third quarter because usually that's an opportunity to let the game get away from you. You know, another team's floor, a team that plays fast-paced like they do, with the ability that they have, you know, they can come out and jump on you in that third quarter and go up 18 to 20. And I just wanted to be assertive and be aggressive and try to impose my will on the game in that stretch. And then just let it be a fourth quarter game and see where it goes.
Coach Scott said he thinks over this last 5 or 6 games that it's the best you've played in your career. Do you think you're playing your best ball right now?
Yeah, I do.
Dave, what did you think about LeBron just having the mic and having to speak in that situation?
Yeah, I thought it was a great speech. He spoke from his heart, and I think what he said, you know, would register with everybody that was in the building and whoever was watching. I think that the most important thing was respect that he showed to Kobe, the honor that he showed. That's what it's about. and I thought that was one of the great speech. And it was really big of him to get up there in front of all those cameras and all those people and be able to share those words.